going to win it. Now, Gary, can I just jump in? Last week, you had the ice bucket challenge on the Footy Show. It was a massive fail. Have a look at this. Gary doesn't get wet. Sam doesn't get wet.
Well, that wasn't our fault.
Not good enough.
Wasn't
only
our fault.
Jim.
Only
well
Jim.
Done, Jim, for standing under there.
That's
but
it.
You're not alone. There's been plenty of fails all around the world.
So
what I've done is a massive fail last week. I've taken matters into my own hands, and I made sure before the show that second time would be a success.
He's here. He's here. Victim number one.
Ah!
You're an
yes.
Idiot.
That's how you do it, Jim.
Guy,
that's how you do it.
I got wet last week, you peanut.
Yeah, but we just don't like you.
Stupid boy.
But it's been a success.
Nothing can compare with Gary at the Balaclava Football Club, the Ice Bucket Challenge there. That was the creme de la creme. Yeah.
What are you talking about?
I don't know. What am I talking about?
Here we are. Oh!
And stretcher.
Nice.
A little double banger there, Gary. That's what we're after.
I had no idea what I was talking about.
Hey.
No
Saturday night at Etihad Stadium, North Melbourne take on Melbourne. The Kangas, just a few outs, but Ferrito's been very good. So has Lindsay Thomas. Greenwood has had a fine season. You can see the outs there. In comes Hanson. Welcome back, J-Mac too. Missed a lot of footy. Wells and Mason Wood is a fine young player from the Geelong Falcons, making his debut. And Daniel Curry as well. Jack Zeeble, fantastic last week. The Demons, Garland and Pedersen come out. And in Riley and McKenzie. And Bernard Vince, Stevie, has had a very good season with his new club.
He has been very good, Jim. But I think the Roos have won the last 12 games against the D's at an average of 44 points. And I think your side will be the danger team going into the finals outside of the top four.
Joey?
Yeah, North Melbourne comfortably.
Yes, I think North Melbourne will win. And what about Paul Roos? Doesn't he love getting right in your face? Have a look at him with Dean Cox. Comes over. Hello, how are you? Going really well, thank you. Yeah, well, that is a bit awkward. And it looked like he was going to give him a bit of a kiss, but Dean Cox's nose gets in the way. And is that
what
is
asked him what he's doing next year, Shane?
Is that a bit close?
Maybe.
It's a bit awkward.
Sam.
Sam.
What? Did you tip, Shane?
Yep. North Melbourne.
North Melbourne.
Congratulations to the Kangaroos
for
getting into the finals.
Exactly.
I had them in. I had them making the eight at the start of the year. Just the next breath after I said Collingwood wouldn't make
it.
And people had written you off, Jim.
That's
and
it.
I think your leadership. You couldn't have done it without. You couldn't have done it without the players. I'll grant you that. But I think you've been extraordinary. What do you mean that they're the danger team outside the top four, Jono? What
well,
the hell
their
that
performances
mean, man?
Against the top sides this year have been as good as anyone, Sam. I think they've beaten Fremantle, Hawthorn. And Sydney.
Yep.
So that's what I mean by the danger team.
So you think they're on the way to maybe the buttered confection?
Well, they say that you can't win premierships from outside of the top four, but if there is a team that I think is likely to beat one of those top sides, it could be North Melbourne.
Well said,
Steve. Right on now, listen.
I've just been quiet about Melbourne, but I've had enough. 12 in a row to Jim's boys, North Melbourne.
Case is of wine coming for me when I stop being a president.
That is a disgraceful performance, and if it shows some balls this weekend against his football club.
Now,
they don't
Gary,
respect
the
you at
over.
All. They've rested half of their team. I heard the captain and the president today talking about the week after, so they don't think it's an event. If you've got any gumption at all, Melbourne, for the last time this year, serve it up to North Melbourne and make a move.
Why don't you go down my track? I said, this is what I said about Richmond. They're as big, they're as strong, they've got the same IQ.
Well, they're not
why
as big and
they...
strong, but Jesus.
Oh, they're not.
All right. Gold Coast take on West Coast. This has got a bearing on the fire rate. This is up at Metricon Stadium. The Gold Coast Suns can still make it, I think, if things fall their way. Warnock, Brilton and Shade and Herbert all come into the squad. Deion Prestia back to some very good form. They play the West Coast Eagles, who can most certainly make the eight if they win and win very comfortably. And Dean Cox is out of the side, by the way, with soreness. Nat Newey comes back in amongst others, along with Scott Selwood. So it's all on the line for both these sides. West Coast win well, things fall their way. Stevie J, they can play finals.
Yeah, I think the Gold Coast have got to win by about 40 goals if they're a chance of getting in. In saying that, I think it's a more important game for West Coast and they'll get the job done.
Joey? Right.
Yeah, tough one. I think West Coast as well. I think West Coast will win.
Thanks. West Coast just.
Seven. No. That's extraordinary, you people.
What? I got nine last week too.
Yeah, it's just I tipped Collingwood not to make the eight. No. the Gold Coast Suns, they will beat the Eagles.
All right, well, I'm going
there.
For West Coast to win and maybe make the
eight. Going to a break, I just want to very quickly say all the best to a great friend of my family, but also many people in the West, Don Breen, who's doing it pretty tough at the moment, and I know he'll be watching. So, Porky, you're much loved by everyone, but especially the Brayshaws. All the best. We're going to take a break. After this, more Big Bill, so stick around for that. Street for, talk from Dan and Ong, almost football legends next on the floor.
Who's the black private dick, the sex machine doll?